I heard from several rectangular-shaped birdies with words on them that you want to see some more swords.
And who could blame you? The art of swordplay is just so goddamn compelling. As a self-proclaimed expert saberist YouTuber famous, I've always been intrigued by the amount of skill and finesse and imaginative mind games involved when simply trying to poke or slash someone with the sharp end of your long metal stick before they do. And then there's VR swordplay, where you don't really need any of that in order to win a fight. Honestly, the dumbest things you can think of will probably still work. And I mean, that can be pretty fun too. However, when you choose to use a little bit more finesse, the outcome can be oh so satisfying. The game that I'm going to be giving myself spikes of dopamine in this time is called Blade and Sorcery, and we're going to pick up from where we left off in the last VR sword fighting video with Hellsplit Arena, where I was just kind of showing you some basic combat fundamentals and techniques, whether offensive, defensive, or otherwise. So take out your notes, take out your swords, and take off your pants, because you need these three qualifiers before we can continue. First things first, I'd like to test out the most infamous Parry 5 riposte before I start showing some new moves. You've chosen a really precarious position to be in, sir. Are you sure that's the most advantageous? Alright, we're gonna try this on someone else. As I was saying, I just wanted to test the effectiveness of the Parry 5 in this game. See if it can hold its own like it did in the last one. Parry 5 post! I think that's evidence. That's good evidence right there. In slow-mo, we're gonna do Parry 5 just so I can show you wasn't a fluke. Just so you can get every last slow motion. Brilliant, graceful fucking movement of this attack. God, there's those spikes of dopamine. Do you dare attack me? Knowing my experience with Saber, you dare swing that flanged mace at me? That's what experience gets you, you know what I mean? That's all experience right there. Let's get some other parries in here. Like the Parry 3, which comes to the right side of your body, and the Parry 4, which comes to the left. Indeed, there are multiple other parries that I've been secretly hiding from you because I don't want you to get too powerful, like me. As you can see, my power is unstoppable. One more to finish you off, Parry 4 riposte. Just like in fencing. Give me that fucking Parry 4. Look how much damage that Parry 4 did. Another Parry 4 for you? How about a fucking third Parry 4? When are you gonna learn? Parry 3, you don't think I come prepared? Parry 4. Uh-oh. An archer. I'll do this until you run out of arrows.
48 arrows later.
My left arm really, really hurts. You're out! You did it! A good, well-to-do, well-trained, big-brain swordsman knows how to use his environment to his advantage, so we're gonna find a way to do that right now. Yes. Yeah, I got that. Was way too funny not to do again. Oh! He's a ghost! Or was the wheel a ghost? I'm getting this thing again. Oh! Now this is one advanced maneuver that I didn't think I had in me. Ready for some slapstick? I can't believe that worked as well as it did. Don't worry, I'm here to give you the slapstick that you desire from this channel. If this man could just get out of the wall real quick, please, sir. I've got a funny joke that I need to do, and you're making it a little difficult. Well, the wall's got him now. There's nothing I can do about that. That's a terminal disease. Oh, I'm so sorry. I just gotta put him out of his misery. There's no helping that. Check out this distance. Look at this max distance I'm putting in between me and her. Look how fucking effective this... About to circle parry this man into oblivion. Give me another. Oof. Disarmed with the circle parry. Now I beat you with your own weapon, you silly goober. A good swordsman always knows how to utilize multiple different weapons at once to their fullest ability. Make sure you take your time. Are you taking notes? Are your pants off?
Hello and welcome to Fight Analysis. In this exchange, we're going to examine how this man right here insults my entire generation in just a couple moves. Analysis. Don't tell anyone this happened to me.
I have a confession to make to you all. There is still one parry that's even more powerful than the parry 5 that I haven't shown you yet, and that's because it is so powerful that if it falls into the wrong hands, this can be a very terrible, awe-inspiring power of powerful capability
power
that engages
power
in multiple
power
capabilities.
Power of power.
It's called the Parry 0, and I'm going to be demonstrating it for you right now.
I used to fence sabers.
The Parry 0. As for an explanation, I think I'm gonna let you try and figure that one out on your own. It would simply be too dangerous if too many people knew the secrets of the Parry 0. Parry 0. You're not supposed to see this part. This is behind the scenes. Stop paying attention. Look away. Look away for just a second. Look back again. Parry 0. There's a really cool climbing and physics system in this game that allows you to, climb your surroundings and interact with the environment. We're gonna ignore what happened a few seconds ago. I almost fell to my death.
Oh, hey there. Why don't you come down here with me? It's pretty fun. It's pretty fun. You're gonna like it. Come on. We all float down. Come down here. Come down here with me.
No. Oh my god, the most dangerous weapon of them all. Come here.
Did you hurt yourself? Did you actually just die from that? No, right? You ran into a wall and died. That wasn't even me.
I still have the most powerful weapon in the game, though. Chicken. Resourcefulness is the name of the game. As a swordsman who's been trained in the fine arts of parrying and riposting. You need to parry or riposte with anything you can get your hands on. And I mean anything. So here, we can see a brilliant parry, chicken parry riposte. Wow. Uh-oh, there's two of you. I'll have to deal with you. And you. Oh my god. Jesus, I've never faced this enemy before. I don't know if I can handle this. He's T-posing at me! I gotta get ahead of here, fuck this! Crafting your own specialty weapons in this game is another important part of being a well-rounded and experienced swordsman. Here I've used a fire enchantment and imbued my weapon so it can pierce through these shields and give me the offensive and defensive edge against literally anything. Let's go see how effective this is. And here we go. Let's test it out. I can't see a goddamn thing. Defending is as simple as moving my wrist left or right to defend my left or right plane. And the shield's just fucking. Another shield to add to my collection? I appreciate that, sir. I'll take that, add it right there like a shish kebab. Oh, my shields!
Here I come! Here I come, you fiend!
Oh no. My shields. Uh-oh. Well,
welcome again to Fight Analysis. In this exchange, well, honestly, there's not much to explain here. Someone else just has to see this. So here we go. This guy falls on the ground, yada yada. Now witness this. Yep, that's absolutely correct. That just happened. Her head landed directly on this guy's face and the impact killed him dead. Just finished him right off like it was nothing. This has been Fight Analysis. We hope you learned something new today.
Oh, jeez, what is that? Oh, no. I'm getting swarmed. I don't think a saber's gonna be enough to help me through this one. I need to switch weapons. A good swordsman knows when to pull out their strongest weapon. And in my case, my shovel technique is one that I'm sure many of you know of to be very, very dangerous. Take the legs, take them out. Take him out midair, dodge the arrow, finish him off, and now we take him to the scoop factory. Scoop. 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 If you pay close attention here, you'll learn how to dig a hole for a beautiful garden. A blood garden! The fantastic thing about the shovel is it's multi-use. We can also use it as a pole vault to get into higher places. I'll send you back to where you came from. The pogoing maneuver is one that I spent years mastering. One that's helped me out through many, many a sticky situation. I'm coming for that archer. Can't hit this. Can't hit this if you tried. Don't even dream of it. What's wrong? Can't hit a moving target? My shovel trick shots are the deadliest in the land. Pogo engage. Off the wall. Reverse pogo shovel shot. There it is. How can you even dream catching a brilliant swordsman like myself? Look at these brilliant swordsman skills that I'm showing to everybody. Gonna have to take this guy out with style. He's the last one. Come over here. Now, what does style look like?
Now that's stylish.
Impressive.
I wouldn't want to be that guy.
Well, he clearly knows what he's doing.
Wait!
What?
What?
If this video tickled you in all the right ways and you'd like to see me play some other VR games, leave a couple of recommendations for me in the comments below. I like ones with swords in them. Oh, and real quick before we end the video, I'd like to see if you retained any of the sword fighting moves I just taught you. So I'm quickly gonna hand the saber off to you. Go ahead and take that and grab my own. And I'd like you to show me up.